Hi! In this video I'm going to show you how to preserve UV maps when moving model geometry in Blender. You can use this technique to quickly adjust already modeled and textured 3D models without touching any UV maps or textures. I'm Steve, you're watching GameDevGems, and we're going to level up your game development skills one gem at a time. Let me show you a practical example. As you can see here, I have a simple 3D model which is fully textured in this beautiful pixel art style. This is for a game I'm working on currently. And I've got this piece from a 3D artist, and my goal is to import this piece into a game engine. In my case it's Unity, but it doesn't really matter, it could also be Unreal Engine or Godot. So while I've reviewed this model in Blender, I've noticed that this part of the model, the bottom part here, is actually geometry that will never be seen by the player. So this is the backside of the model, and that's the front side, and the player will only ever see this part of the wall. And he will never see the back portion of this floor. So one thing I could do is to actually go into edit mode. I'll select the vertex here. Make sure that the auto merge vertices option is turned on. And then I press G to grab a vertex. And let's say I want to snap it to this vertex here. And maybe I take this vertex and snap it to this vertex over here. And we're pretty much done. We've removed this part of the geometry. I can only ever see this part. We're good to go, right? Well, technically, no, because what we've now did is that we've actually stretched this part of the texture here. It's pretty hard to see, but while we move the geometry, and I can actually showcase this here, when I move this vertex, as you can see, the whole texture that's mapped on top of it is stretched. That's not something that we want. To better illustrate what I'm talking about, let's move this model to the side, and we'll start by actually adding a simple plane to our scene. Next, I will assign a material and test texture to this model. I'll do this by using the Texel density checker add-on. So in here, I will actually press the assign checker material button, and what it does is that it actually applies a material, a test material, that you can use to check UV maps and these kind of things, and applies it to our model. So now let's set the texture size to 1K. And yeah, that looks pretty good. Now onto the problem itself. So let's again go into edit mode and select the vertex. I've showed you that when I move the vertex around, the texture is actually stretched. So depending on the use case, this is actually something you may or may not want to do. In our case, however, as we illustrated earlier, we want to preserve the UVs when modifying the geometry. And there's actually two ways to do this. The first option is to use the vertex slide tool. To access this tool, we're going to edit mode, we're going to select a vertex, and we're gonna double press the G key, so GG, and this enables this tool. And what this tool actually does, it uses the constraints of the mesh and moves the vertex along its connected edges, and at the same time preserves the UVs, as you can see. So there's no stretching happening. You can actually toggle between the grab tool and the slide tool by pressing G again. So I press G and now I'm in the normal move tool, and I press G again and I'm back to the vertex slide tool. The same tool also works with edges. To do this, we select an edge of the mesh and then we again double press the G key. As you can see, the vertex slide tool applies, press G, normal move tool is activated. There's an alternative way to select the vertex slide or edge slide tool. And we can do this by actually, let's say we select this vertex again and we press Shift V, and this automatically directly activates the corresponding slide tool. So depending on if I have an edge selected or if I have a vertex selected. When using the slide tool, you can press the left mouse button to confirm the transformation. Once you do so, an options shelf appears in the lower left portion of the screen here. And there you can see a correct UVs option. And this is the reason the UV correction actually works when using the slide tool. Since Blender 2.8 or so, this option is automatically applied when you use this tool. Toggling said option on or off, unsurprisingly, also turns UV correction on or off. And you can see the effect that we had when we just grabbed the tool versus when we used the slide tool. The second option is to again select the object, go into edit mode, and we navigate to the active tool shelf. The active tool shelf is actually found in the sidebar here. And should the sidebar missing for you, can press the N key to toggle the menu on and off. Alternatively, you can go to the properties editor, which is found in the bottom right here. And then you press on the active tool and workspace settings. In here, let's go to the toolbar up here. Those are the same options here. You open the options shelf here, and then you're gonna toggle the correct face attributes option. Enabling this option will make Blender automatically correct UVs as you modify the mesh by dragging and moving geometry around, as you can see here. So in this case, the difference to the slide tool is that you are actually not constrained by the mesh geometry. You can even move beyond the model UV, and Blender will automatically extend, or so to say tile, the UV map instead of stretching it. So now let's get back to our model and apply what we've learned. We can delete this plane. We're gonna move back our mesh here. We're gonna go into edit mode. In this case, I'm gonna re-toggle the correct face attributes option here. I'm gonna select this vertex. I'm gonna move it to this vertex. I'm gonna snap to it. We still have the auto merge vertices option selected, so these vertices are actually merged into one. I'm gonna do the same with this one, and let's take a look. Yep, that looks great. The texture hasn't been modified. This looks all well and good to me, and I can actually go ahead and export the model into Unity. That's it for this quick tip. Today we've learned how to quickly modify model geometry without affecting UV maps. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and consider subscribing for more game development tips in the future. I also have this video in written form on my website. It's linked in the video description below. Thank you, and see you next time on GameDevGems. Keep on developing.